The notion that 2.5% 5-year, I like to look at the 5-year note a little bit better than the 10-year because it's a little bit less direct interest rate risk. And I think mom and pop investors, if they could have bought a 2.5% 5-year note 3 or 4 years ago, you know that they would have been just falling over themselves to buy that. And now they can, and yet the momentum is still scaring them away. So I think what's happening is that you'll see a greater level of interest as we get greater levels of volatility in the equity market and other risk assets like high yield and bank loans and maybe even emerging markets. But the way things are working today, I think the equity market is the third derivative. I think interest rates are the second derivative, and I think the first derivative is a change in policy from $15 trillion of QE stimulus by the three major central banks to now we're actually moving to a QT environment. And I think that changes the rules of the game from what we've been used to in the last 7 or 8 years.
Doug, is that why interest rates are going up? Or is it, other people argue, no, it's because the economy is getting better? Or
well, I think it's
inflation,
a combination.
Or are the bond vigilantes fearful about all the debt that's going to be issued?
I think it's a combination of all those things. But don't forget, we had a lot of debt. We had big deficits. And when the QE was alive and well, interest rates were falling. And so now we're going to have greater growth. There's no doubt about that. We can argue about inflation. I would argue that actually we did see inflation that was caused by QE. We just didn't see it in the consumer price index or the core PCE. We saw it in asset prices. And everybody now is worried we're going to start to see some goods price inflation or some service price inflation. I think that's probably appropriate at this stage of the economic cycle.
But the question, Guy Adami, is how do you factor in what seems inexorable, which is what's going to happen to earnings here, right? And also what Michelle talked about, which is the economy. It looks like we're ratcheting up a 2.5% economy compared to a 2%, maybe even a 3% economy. All the earnings have been outstanding, and all the other stuff, to my mind, Guy, is noise compared to the actual earnings and the earnings outlook.
I agree, and I don't think the stock market, the fall in the stock market over the last couple of days should not affect earnings at all. Earnings have been very strong. They should continue to get stronger. Look at what the GDP forecast went from 4.2% on Friday to 5.5%.
No, it didn't.
Well,
that's a stupid forecast, that's another story.
It's a stupid forecast, not stupid forecast.
No,
not
it's gonna, totally stupid, but go ahead.
Somebody, it wasn't my forecast.
No, so don't repeat it. Yeah.
Fair enough. Good. But you understand, the economy seems to be getting better. You have ISM numbers through the roof. You have optimism through the roof. So why should the stock market selling off have any effect whatsoever on what Mr. Powell
is trying to do? It's important to say because you have had an important wealth effect from stock prices. You've seen it in a variety of places, and people have been spending. You've seen the savings rate come down.
Dow was off 607 points.
And you do have an economic effect from lower stock prices. You have a tightening of financial conditions that does have a macro effect. And Powell will note this. It is part of the playbook of the Federal Reserve that when equity prices decline, financial conditions tighten, and it ends up doing some of the Fed's work for it if it's trying to break the economy.
We agree the stock market is not the economy. They are different things.
Oh, it's a derivative reflection of it. That's what Doug was talking about.
Okay, but what is that derivative relationship? Because you mentioned that the odds of 4 rate hikes maybe being pulled back to just 3, which leads us to think that Mr. Powell and the other Fed chairs would indeed be looking at the equity market, but some others might say, no, no, that's just a side story. You've covered the Fed forever. How much do you believe that in their quiet, dark moments, they look at stock prices?
Not quiet and dark anymore, Brian. In the old days, the stock was something they looked at but didn't say they looked at it or admit it. More and more, the stock market is seen as a conduit of Federal Reserve policy. And that was a big part of what happened in the financial crisis.
Seems risky.
It is risky, and right now they're seeing financial conditions tighten. But not, look, the Fed's going to take a step back from this. We are looking at the percentage change from the top. The Fed's going to look at the percentage change from a year ago, and they're still going to see lots of wealth in the economy, lots of stock wealth. And by the way, people look at their portfolios and say, you know what, I was up 30, now I'm up 25. Not too shabby still.
Hey there, thanks for checking out CNBC on YouTube. Be sure to subscribe to stay up to date on all of the day's biggest stories. You can also click on any of the videos around me to watch the latest from CNBC. Thanks for watching.